Alright, people, welcome back to the finale of the Fire Emblem 8 Randomized Redux. Alright, let's go. So we have a bit of a problem with these two. They both have Shadow Shot. Do I have anyone that can effectively tank a Shadow Shot? Our girls can. You know, Vanessa's been putting in work. I'd say it's because of her class, but it's kind of her class and the fact that she got, and the fact that she's gonna cap out speed. No, she actually got magic. Well, hurry. Now she hits harder. So now we need to start tanking blows. And we're gonna fight these glugly. We have cap speed. The glugly can't do anything to us. And of course we're gonna give Seth support as usual. Cause, you know, always feels nice to have a god under you. A god, you know, just hanging by you, chilling by you, giving you the feeling that you're gonna win. Sucks that Murr doesn't have her support in the end, because Ephraim was capped out on supports. The only other people she supported with was Sayla, and Sayla died. Take this, boogie. Strength! Yay! Strength! Oh, holy crap! You know, I never actually ever noticed this. Holy crap, look at that architecture. Yo! Shit is stellar. What? I never noticed this before. Alright, enough admiring good architecture. We need to take out all these arch moguls. And we can do it with our Ines and loot supports. Though I don't think I'd want Ines in the thick of it. And besides, we have the twins. We have the twin support, you know, they're getting their supports. Take this, Gwilgi! You know, Leon's gonna be a little bit difficult. He's gonna be a little bit difficult. He does 55 damage. He does 55 damage. Well, he does 55 minus resistance. But who can tank that? Like, Joshua only has 9 res. Arguably, Lamo could at full health. Garrett could after a pure water. Gilliam after drinking a pure water. Ephraim after pure water. LaRachel after pure water, but she won't do any. She can't do damage. She can't do damage. Oh, ow, that Woolgy actually hit me. Okay, finally. I wanted to bait out Shadow Shots. Shoot. Alright, we're getting lucky. We're getting just a little bit lucky, but I need to keep on baiting out Shadow Shots. Alright, sweet. Yay, wow, he does 22. What the heck? What do I do? How much move do you have? 6? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Bam, and he hits me. Speaking of, did I only have 30 health? Because he only does 10 damage. We'll take this, Woolgy. Anyone got a pure water? Or anyone want a pure water? After this Archmogul is dead, provided he doesn't. Okay, never mind. Joshua's gonna have to take a shadow shot to the face. Like, I'm gonna sit here. I'm literally going to wait until their shadow shots go away. You think I'm kidding? Nah, man. Last shadow shot for you, girl. Good, it's the last shadow shot for her. Now it's time to drain this one's shadow shot. Oh yeah, drink. Okay, delicious. Just dodge it. No. Well, then again, I have two healers on healers, but I'll be right back. Alright, we're back with the mayhem. In recent news, I drained these two girls dry of their shadow shots, so we don't have to deal with that anymore. So what I think I'm going to do is I'm going to play a little bit recklessly. Ah, yes, recklessness. My favorite. And how I plan to do that is I'm going to move you back here and use the power of supports to fuel your destruction of general life. Put Brother Boy right here to tank it up a little bit, you know? Ooh, maybe I shouldn't do that. Maybe, let me see, if I move Rachel right here, we're getting that clean support range. I'll put Vanessa right here. Because of Slayer, she'll do that, completely wreck everything in the way. Because Slayer is so good. Speed, right? Yeah, about what I expected. Then we put loot in support range. And what I'm thinking is that I place Brother Boy behind Sister. Then we move Joshua over here. Because Joshua's going to need to tank some hits. So we'll equip that Silver Lance and drink a pure water. Gonna put Garrick into the range, as well as Ines. Garrick and Murr just hanging out. So we're gonna charge the front line. They're gonna come after us. Ooh, LaRachel, let's go. Defense? That's weird. Ooh, Stone, you're trying to get us to smoke that dang weed? No thanks. No, I'm not interested in your weed. Right, so now we've taken care of that business, we can kill this Gorgon. Yikes, I would've liked to do it in one because Demon Surge hurts. And I want to move up on these stone ladies. And, ooh, I can wipe out the stone girl in one, two hits. Bam, one hit. Alright, move Seth into Lamo support range. This is perfect. I just want this Gorgon dead, to be honest. Now that you're dead, we can do this. Divine in the face. Ow, he actually hit me, fucker. Let's go, Vanessa. Oh wow. Oh wow. If only she had S rank. Well, we can beat Leon right now. Let me see something. Oh. God. Dang, dude. So let me see if my math is correct. Let me pull up a calculator. I need a calculator for this. So Seth is doing 24. Lute is doing 30. 24 plus 30 is 54. And Joshua's doing 14. See, no. Joshua was doing 18, so. A 54 and 18 is 72. If we're gonna put Lamo into the mix, then. No, we're not. How much does Garrick do? He does 18, so we will kill Leon. We just have to do this right. Oh no, Luke gets one-shotted. So we have to save Luke for last. So let's start with Seth. Wait, we could clear up this Gorgon for space. Since Lamo isn't doing anything. I suppose we can just have her clear up this Gorgon. Yeah, perfection. Alright, so let's get this did. I hope he gets a crit. Because that's a full wipe if he gets a crit, like... Actually, never mind, that's not. So, you took your damage. Come on, do something good for me, Garrick. You're in your support range. Oh man, 3 crit. That scares me. Oh, hey, 27 damage. Which means Joshua will wipe him out right now. Where did I go wrong? Got lost it, babe. Oh, hey, Nils. Yeah, you're too strong. I've always admired your strength. Yeah, I wanted to be better than you. Yeah. Wanted to be better than you, wanted to take your sister, yeah, okay. Hey, it's the Demon King. Yeah, man. So scary. Let's see how scary he truly is, because he has question mark hit points. Yikes. Oh my god. Oh god. No. Whoa. Oh. Oh god. Oh no. Oh no. Oh whoa. Bruh. That's all I can say about that. I guess Lamo isn't too good for this fight. I know Formidus or, well, Formortus, whatever his name is. That's the 1 to 3 range thing. That's a punch, which is 1 range. That's a 2 range weapon. So I'll definitely want to move Joshua right here. Garrick's right behind him. Oh my god. What do I do? What do I do? Oh god! Okay, I need supports. Together we ride, guys. Ride or die for squad. It's a shame you didn't get anything past the B rank. In light magic, that would have been helpful. Ooh, your Sigmund. Sigmund will come in handy. I know you waste the first turn summoning monsters. Yeah, cool. Do you do any damage, Garrick? You do 17 and you get your ass doubled. Oh my god. What the fuck? It's insane. Oh my god. This is insanity! Dude, are we just gonna sack members? Because at this point, I could care less. Well, Adhoma will do well. How much, shoot. I mean, we can sack Gilliam. How much does Joshua do? We even doubles him. So that's 30. I just wanted to do that so we can get some massive support range. I want to get as much support range for Joshua as possible, since he's going to be making moves on 4 meters. And I suppose we can... Aw, man, I bet Luke gets one-shotted, which he does. Seth does not get one-shotted. Oh my lord, we have to make a move. We have to make a move. Joshua, you god. Joshua, you're a beast. You're a true beast. You're the real goat. You are the goat, like. Oh my god. So Seth is the next person that doesn't get doubled. He loses out on Lamo's support range, though. But at this point, all we need is damage. All I'm asking for is damage. I don't even mind sacking Gilliam for the sake of the squad. Oh man, we can't sneak up behind him and get the Adhoma. Right, so I want support range. I want support range. Wow, Ines gets one-shotted. Have we got anything else that will be effective? That doesn't work because she's not a Lord class. Thank you. Gilliam, you have to hit this. You have to hit this. Do it for me. Thank the Lord Almighty. Sorry, Gilliam. I kind of sent you on a death march, but that's okay. Because you were prepared for anything. That's all I needed. You did it for me. You the real MVP, Gilliam. You're the real MVP. Hit it. Gilliam was the true goat. It's over, guys. We did it. We conquered. We set out and we conquered. Blam. Well, I'm happy. Hey, Redak, the heck? Fam, please, like, Redak, you're a dick, like, nah, fam, what are you doing actually fighting like you're worth something? Hey, Walter's Assault. It feels good to be done, you know, how do I put it, it feels good to get a finale out of the way, you know, actually finish something we set out to do, heck yeah, but I don't think we're done yet, cause we're not. Not technically done here, because I have one more thing for this. It's just gonna hit the right spot. To be honest, I really did enjoy all of this, though I did get kinda annoyed at some points, like with certain people that I should have killed off in the final chapter, like Yuen. You know what, I should have just brought them as death fodder, like, just honestly, like, I should have brought everyone I found useless and killed them. I almost thought that I literally could not do it, because we had no one, we were locked. But look at what we've done in the end. We pulled off the Rush Reeve strat, we killed the Demon King on the second turn. With Gilliam's sacrifice, but these are things I can live with, cause Gilliam is Gilliam, you know. But you know, these are things I'm okay with. At least in the end, we were able to do it with a limited party. Like you saw on some maps when we could bring like 17 characters and such. And we were only bringing maybe 10 or 11 people. So, you know, that that's just honestly amazing. We did it with a limited crew. I wasn't able to get the Master Card or the Silver Card. Not the Master Card. The Member Card. I wasn't able to get the Member Card or the Silver Card. So we did that. Basically, we were just overall, like, crippled to hell in this playthrough. Ooh, man, the turn count. You guys will get to see awful turn counts. Oop, I was support grinding there. I was support grind. Nope, that's when I was searching for stuff. Support grinding. Hey, Seth, boy Seth. Mm-hmm. Oh gosh. I hate how long these things take. But I also do like looking at the little epilogue-y stuff. Oh, he died. Died. Hey, Bishop. Yeah, you're cool. Dead. Oh, Nemi. Nemi is one of my greatest regrets for this playthrough because I didn't get a Knight's Crest for her. Like, I couldn't get a Knight's Crest for her because I had forgotten to get it at, in chapter, 19 with Renee Castle. Oh, fuck you, like, piece of shit. Ha, loot the bow god. She may have only had 30 hit points, but Dodge Tank Supreme, her bows, archers are like ass cheeks because of archers, but you can't have a team without an archer. Oh man. Joshua the MVP, without a doubt. Without Joshua, I don't think I would have ever been able to finish this game. I don't think I would have ever been able to finish. Like, fuck you. Died. Dead. Bye. Ha, Swordmaster. Him and Sayla came in clutch when I needed them. And thank goodness for their existence. Well, Sayla died, but thank goodness for him and Sayla. Aw, you died. It's just garbage. Hey, Garrick. He had no speed. Good magic. No speed. At least he was there to wield the Excalibur when no one else could. I would have given it to Sayla, but, you know. Ugh, you were garbage. Actually, I'm not gonna skip this. Ewan, you garbage piece of shit. Like, how dare you even exist? How dare you even try to... No. You're the worst character I've ever seen in my life. I can't... No. I hate you too. You died. You replaced Nemi. Hey, lame-o lord. I originally thought she was going to be the worst ever, like, the worst character we've ever had to deal with. And that was wrong. She really turned around. And she said, you know what? You thought I was gonna be garbage? But here's what's up. Here's what's up. We're gonna save the day. LaRachel, she came in clutch at the last chapter. And Ephraim was bland. But we're not technically done yet. Because I want this to replace the other playlist. Or, well, the other playthrough. I want this completely replace it. I'm getting rid of that other playthrough because I'm tired of looking at it. So what I'm going to do is I'm actually going to save the finale for, the finale is going to have all the cutscenes, and I'm going to just talk over them, you know? It'll be like a podcast. I don't know, not a podcast. Well, I guess, what's the word I'm looking for? I'm getting stupid. I'm turning stupid. Well, you know what? We'll just call it a podcast. Because that's pretty much what it'll be. You're not going to be focusing on what's going on in the story, because the story's awful. You'll just, you know, just be watching it for what I have to say. But regardless of such, we're done here. I deeply hope everyone enjoyed. I mean, even if you didn't, that's okay. I don't mind that, but I hope you guys did, because that would make me happy. This could have ended up way worse. I realize that. Oh my gosh. Yo, 4 minutes was pretty freaking dangerous. Like, I for a second thought we were screwed. Like, yo, actually, to be honest, if Joshua hadn't gotten that crit, we would have died. We've been dead. But I digress. We're done here. I hope you people enjoyed as much as I did, because I actually had a lot of fun with this. I really did. I definitely gotta try this again. I definitely gotta try this again sometime. But we got other things to do at the moment, so yeah, don't feel afraid to, you know, hit the like button, leave a nice comment or a bad comment, leave whatever you want to say to me about this. All the feedback you got for me, just leave it right there. And don't forget to hit the subscribe button. Not that I'm asking you to, I mean, it'd be a nice thing to do. And I definitely appreciate it. But for now, I'll see you guys next time, or next playthrough, or I'm rambling, see you guys later.